Hey everybody, I'm Chef Tom with ATBBQ.com, and I'm excited to welcome my good friend, Eric Gephardt. He's the chef and culinary director over at Kamado Joe to bring you this recipe video today. Now, we love cooking on Kamado Joes, which is why we carry them in our store here at All Things Barbecue, and nobody knows more about cooking on Kamado Joe than Eric Gephardt. So enjoy the recipe, enjoy the video, and thanks for watching.
Hey Dream Team, Eric Gephardt here at Kamado Joe, coming to you from Wichita, Kansas at All Things Barbecue. Today we're gonna be doing one of my favorite dishes, Chilean sea bass. All right, we're gonna sear this on the soapstone, create a steam effect on the soapstone, and then top it with teriyaki glaze and wasabi peas and serve it over a really nice sweet potato mash. Let's get it going. All right, so we're set at 500 degrees. Let's look and see how we've got the grill set up. Divide and conquer system is set up such that our soapstone is at the highest position. I've got all my coals banked to the left side of the grill. That way we're getting a lot more heat off this stone. Feeling good heat. And then down low over here, I've got a grill grate, which we're gonna put a sauce pot and make a sauce while our fish is finishing up. We've reached smoking point. That's what we're looking for. We're gonna go presentation side down. We want a really nice sear on that presentation side, so we're gonna let that sit. I can hear it sizzling, the Maillard reaction is occurring, proteins are turning to sugar. Notice I didn't season that fish before I put it down. Chilean sea bass is one of those fish that when you buy it, generally it's FAS, frozen at sea, it retains a lot of moisture content. If you're gonna season this fish in the very beginning, it's gonna start pulling out moisture and you're gonna have a harder time getting a fantastic sear. Sear's almost set on our presentation side. Let's go ahead and get our pot heating up. It's important to note, this handle's gonna be hot, so let's try our best to remember not to grab this handle. I can see a nice bit of caramelization occurring. That means our sear is almost there. You don't want a dry sear, so we're gonna flip that in just a second. But let's go ahead and get our sauce started. We're gonna start with some white wine. Now we're gonna go in with a bit of lemon. Get primal with it. This is gonna be the base of our lemon beurre blanc. Don't worry about the seeds, you'll be fine. Beautiful. I'm gonna put these side by side so that our steam technique will work. We've already flipped the fish, now's the time to put just a little seasoning on top. We're gonna put a bowl over our fish, a little water, create a steamer. All right, let's take a look. It's getting there, let's shoot a little more water in there, create a little more steam action. White wine and lemon juice have reduced a little bit. We're gonna turn this into a lemon beurre blanc. Let's knock in a little heavy cream just for body. We'll bring that to a simmer. Let's take a look at our fish. Steamer's worked very nice for us. You can start to see some of the albumin coming out of the side. We're almost there. This is one of those fish that you can almost overcook. It gets to that point, it's not gonna dry out, it's just gonna get more and more flaky. I'm not saying overcook the fish, but take it a little further than you would any other white fish. Let's take a look. Beautiful. Let's get a little of our glaze on top. That's a teriyaki glaze, now we go on with our wasabi peas. I've got some nice bubbles here that cream and white wine and lemon juice have reduced. Now it's time to mount in the butter. Make a nice butter sauce here. You want to slowly incorporate that butter and not break the sauce. Now we'll go in with a little salt in the sauce. Season it slightly. We made some sweet potato maple puree. Look how that sauce is just naturally come together. Absolutely stunning. So that's that. A remarkable dish, but really simple to do. The divide and conquer system really allows us to play around with different cooking methods. So yeah, we're using a grill, but we also roasted, we seared, we steamed, we made a lemon beurre blanc. We had a lot of fun. Let's give it a shot. Get some of that sauce on there. Oh my gosh. Yahtzee.
Thanks so much for watching, and thanks to Eric for being here today. Be sure to check out atbbq.com for all of the products featured in today's video, including those Kamado Joe grills. And if you enjoyed that video, we'd appreciate it if you hit the subscribe button. If you have any questions or comments, please let us know in the comment section down below. For more recipes, tips, and techniques, head over to thesauce.atbbq.com. All things barbecue, where barbecue legends are made.